Hello guys, my name is HArdevinder. We are going to solve ICT paper, Information and Communication Technology of IGCSE. This paper is of Feb-March 2019, paper 31, Data Analysis and Web Authring, Website Authring. In this video, we will cover website authoring part. In the next video, we will discuss data analysis. So let us start. Before starting, I want to inform you, while solving this paper, we have used all open source softwares. Like operating system, we are going to use Ubuntu, the Linux, and the word processor, we are going to use LibreOffice. And for photo editing, we are going to use GIMP, all open source softwares. We are not going to use any Microsoft product while solving this paper. And for solving a data analysis, also we will use all open source softwares. So let us start with the question one. So first is a task one, evidence document. To open the file m1931 evidence.rtf, make sure your name, center number, and candidate number appears on every page of your evidence document by placing these in header. Save the word processed document in your Word area with the file name this evidence, followed by your candidate number and the example, this one. They have given the example. You will have to write the name of the file and followed by your candidate number. You will need to place screenshot and your answers in the evidence document. So let us open this file. So here we are having a source folder, and here is this one. Open with LibreOffice Writer. I told you we are going to use LibreOffice instead of Microsoft, all open source softwares. So we have opened. As they have told, we'll have to place in a header. Here is a header. Go in view, insert, and here is header section, and here header. In a header, we'll have to write your name, Arvinder Singh. And center number, suppose that is a N0001, suppose. And suppose the candidate number is 0001. Whatever your candidate number, you will have to write in the header. So let us move further. The second task is, we'll have to save it with the word processor software. So save as, give the name is same, followed by your candidate number, which is 0001, and save. While saving, it will ask for use ODF format or use rich text format. It's already in a rich text format, but we need to save it in a word processed format, and this ODF is a word processor format. So we'll have to save with this one and save it. Error, saving document, evidence document already exists. It's already exist. I think I have already opened this. We'll have to close it first, not save. So now we need to save it again. File, save as 0001, then save, ODF format, save. So this has been saved. Let's move to the next question. This is a task two, web page. You will evaluate the web page designed for children aged 2 to 3 to help them identify colors. When they click on a word, the name of the color is output through speakers and the color appears in circle. The web page looks like this. The colors for the colors for you, and this is a web page they have given to us. We'll have to evaluate this as an audience. So suppose you are the audience. Suppose you are the 2 to 3 years old audience. Suppose you are more than, I think, 13, 14, 12 years, more than 12 years old. But imagine, and suppose you are the 2 to 3 years old audience. So just think that, is it attractive for you? Is it helpful for you to identify the colors? I think if we will go down and we'll think that at the age of 2 to 3 years, it is not much attractive. And just to see, I'll show you a page. I have also designed the page to make you a clear which type of the web page should be for the 2 to 3 years old students. So this page I have designed just to illustrate which type of a page should be for the 2 to 3 years old students. But if you see in detail, here we have put the buttons. Click here to see the yellow, blue, red, green, a purple. So To instructions, we have written a very in large size and bold and in different colors. So it attracts more to the children. If you see the kids of 2 to 3 years, it is a more attractive. And the instructions are bold in big in size. The shapes are also more as compared to this one. This they have given only a single shape, circle. Here we have 1, 2, 3, and 4 shapes. So it is a more attractive. So the kids, it will be entertaining for the kids. You can make more attractive web page, but I tried my best to illustrate the which type of a web page should be. And instead of writing a test, we have given the buttons of different colors. This will attract the students. Let us try and click. What happens? Here, yellow, blue, red, green, purple. So it's a big in size, and the children, if can't read, they can see this. These are the buttons. Let us try by clicking these buttons. So we can put the hover also. Right now the hover is not here. Just to click the button, let us try and click the button. They will come to know the about the colors. They can identify the colors, and we can add the sound and voice also as they have given in their question. So kids, what you think? Okay, what are the problems? What are the deficiencies in this? What can be improved in this page? I think the instructions, they have written colors for you, and the instructions they have written here, click on the name of the color to see in the circle. It's too small in size. It's a difficult for the children to read out. If they read, then it's very difficult to identify which color is this. They have written a test in too small size, and this all in black and white. I don't think it may be a colorful, but it's showing to us as a black and white. So we will consider it as it is in a black and white. So imagine which type of page you think. You don't need to develop this page. You don't need to waste your time for developing this page to illustrate the examiner. You have a very less time. Within 2.5 hours, you have to complete your paper. So you can just imagine this page in your mind, and you can write which type of page should be, which type of the page should be designed for the kids. As an audience, you will have to think and write, okay, which as an audience, which type of page I want if I am in the age of 2 to 3, so that it will be easier for the kids to understand, identify the colors. So let us write our evaluation in this place here, your evaluation. They have written, evaluate the web page for the attendant audience. Type your evaluation into your evidence document using no more than 100 words. So let us write our evaluation within the limit of 100 words. So firstly, the web page design for children to identify the colors should be more attractive as follows. Very first thing, instructions written, click to see the color. Should be large in size and colorful. Names of colors should be in buttons instead of simple and small size text. The page should be colorful. There should be more shapes as instead of single circle. which will attract more 2 to 3 years children audience. So guys, you can imagine the page which I have shown you in your mind, and according to your imaginations, compare this which they have given in a question paper and write your wordings. We have written 119 words, so means approximately near about 100. So don't worry if 10-15 words, if you have written more, don't worry, or less, it's okay. So you can write your evaluation accordingly. You don't need to, again I'm telling you, you don't need to just waste your time to develop this page. You can imagine this page in your mind and write accordingly. And don't think that we'll have to write only 100 words or less than 100 only. If you have exceeded for 10, 15, 20 words, it doesn't matter. But your line should be clear and complete. You have just to limit the words up to 100 only. Your line is not complete. It will not attract the examiner, and it will not be understandable to him what you want to say. So complete your sentence. If the words are exceeding, don't worry. So let us move for the next question. State the most appropriate web development layer 2. So students, you must be knowing there are web layers like structure and content layer, presentation layer, behavior layer, or the work of HTML, where we structure the page, comes under a structure and content layer, and all decorations and like CSS comes under a presentation layer, and all JavaScript features like clicking and event handling, all these things comes under a JavaScript. And as I've shown you here, this designation of these buttons and this colors, this text, font size, and all these things comes under a CSS. This is a presentation layer, and the structure of this page comes under a structure and content layer. And while clicking on the page, we are getting the different color. These things comes under the JavaScript layer, which is a behavior layer. So behavior means just event handling. While clicking, something should happen like this. So all these things comes under a behavior layer. And the structure of page, your HTML code, that comes under a structure and content layer. And decoration, the color changes, and font size, all these comes under a presentation layer. So let us solve this question. The first is, set the background color of all the pages in our website. So setting a background color and all these comes under a presentation layer, and you can do this well in a CSS. So CSS comes under a presentation layer. The create a hyperlink to another web page, that comes under a structure in HTML code. Here we don't need to CSS. Here directly you can do in the HTML. So this is a structure and content layer. And the next is collapse of table borders. Again, these things can be done in a CSS. Collapse of table borders means the table borders of table should not show. So collapse there, and they should be in a collapse form. So this we can do in a CSS. This is also comes under a presentation layer. And the enlarge the size image when use hover the cursor over it, means if we will bring our cursor on a shape, that image should enlarge, means hover. So these things are in a JavaScript. These things we can do in a JavaScript, means in a present, this is a behavior layer. So let us attempt this question in our evidence document. Evidence 2, type your answers into your evidence document. The first answer is, they have given options. The first answer, first question is, set the background color of the page in a website, that comes under a presentation layer. So here we can write presentation layer. The second is, create a hyperlink to another page that we have discussed. This is a structure content layer. The next is collapse of table borders. This comes under a presentation layer again. Presentation layer. The next is enlarge the image size when the use hover the cursor over it. This is a JavaScript feature and this comes under a behavior layer. So this question also we have discussed. Let us move for the next question. Next is, you work for a hot house design and will develop a web page for the small British company called Glorious Gardens. Efficient markup and style sheet must be used. All color codes must be in hexadecimal. So students, keep in mind, we'll have to use efficient markup and style sheets. So keep in mind the word efficient. Efficient means we should use the code efficiently. We can use markup and style sheet both to design the page. And the colors should be in hexadecimal. These things keep in mind while solving or while developing or designing your page. So create a new folder called GGG.html. So here we are having a source file. Here we can create a new folder. That is the name of folder should be GGG_HTML. So here is our source code here. So this folder we have created as the dev instructor. Locate the following files and store them in your folder, GGG.html folder, apple, camellia jpg, cherry, forsythia, GGG.png, GGGstyle.css, GGTest.est, LILAC.jpg. Let us locate these all files. Where are the files? Apple, Camellia. This we don't need. I think this also category. Category didn't ask for that. Cherry, Forsythia, GGGLogo.png. GGGstyle.css, GGTest, yes. I think pre-code we need or not? No need. Pre-code is for the second task, I think. Oh, these are total 9 items. So they have asked for the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 items. 1, 2, 3. 5, 6, 7, 8 items, and we have copied 9 ones, which is extra. I think GGGTest. This is also asked. Apple. First check Apple. Camellia, cherry. Forsythia, GGG logo, GGG style, yes. I think all these are required here. So these are 8 items. Let us copy. Test also required. Let us copy all this, don't worry. So save here and paste here, which is not required, don't worry. So let's move further. Open and resize the image, this image, so that it is 672 pixels wide and 896 pixels high. Save the image with the file name this in the same folder. So for resizing, we can use the software GIMP. Here we are having a GIMP. So still then it is opening. Let us read the second question. Remove the left and right of the image to make 271 pixels wide and 896 pixels high like this. Save this image with this one. So this is ready. On discard. So this is opened. We are having this image. This one. You have to edit open with GIMP. We need to resize this image. 672 wide and 896 pixels high. Image, scale image. So width we can set 672. 672. It has automatically been set as an aspect ratio, I think. Then scale. Don't worry, this is not actual size of the image. It's not 100%, it's at 12.5%. This actual image. So we need to save it with this name. Means you need to put the one. So file, export as. Yeah, you can put the one and export. The next question they are asking for, remove the left and right of the image to make it 271 pixels wide and 896 pixels high. Means from both the sides we'll have to discrop it in equal, this side and this side. Right now we are having 672 pixels wide and we'll have to cut. How much we need to cut? Let us check. Insert 672 minus 271. Means 401 pixels we'll have to cut. Means 200 pixels from each side we need to cut. 200.5 pixels we need to cut from each side. So here we are having a crop tool. It's a crop tool. And we need to position it on the top. And from left side, we need to position it at a 200.5. So here position we need to, here is a position. Left position. This X coordinates. X means top. X so let us position 0 200.5. And the size we need 271 pixels wide and 896. Width should be 296 and 896. Here is a 200. Let us see from here. Here is 200 and it should be wide 296, I think. Okay. Yes. So then drag down here. Guys, we are just somewhere, we are doing something wrong. I think from here we need to start. So guys, you can use this crop tool and you can place it here. Just, and here you can set the position as we decided it should be 200.5 from on X coordinates from left side and exactly on the top. And the size they have told 271 by 896. So this is done. They have told this has been cropped out. 271 by 896 and 200 is the position. This 271 by 896 and it has been cropped out. So one now need to save it with another name. That is this one. So file export as 2. export. So guys, we need to check the properties here. Dimensions, you will see 672 by 896, and the second one 271 by 896. Second should be for this image 672 by 896. Now with this 672 and 896, I think we have done something wrong. We didn't save it properly. This image, we have cropped down it, so we did something. So guys, let me do it again. Something have happened wrong while saving it. The students will have to save it with a PNG, I think, not instead of JPG. So instead of this, we need to save it using a transparent. So guys, we'll solve this again. Open this image, we need to open it, and then we need this crop tool. Let's set here position 200 and the size they have told 271 by 896. 271 by 896. Let me check again. 271 by 896, yes. So now double click, right click, image, crop to content. We have to click here, crop to content. Now this has been done, and then save. Instead of save as, export as. Export as, here we'll have to set the 2. Export. Why this has been done? Let me check. This is properties, dimensions 271 by 896, and here 672 by 896. Let's move further. Display the content of GG folder, showing the folder name, all the names, extensions and size of the image, dimensions. Take a screenshot of your GGG HTML folder and place this in your evidence document. So we need to show the size is also showing, modified date, and visible columns. Type also, owner we don't need, this is MMA type. Okay, location, time, search, modified time also we have showed. So let us take a screenshot of this. Screenshot, take, grab the full screen, select the area to grab, select the area to take screenshot. This much area we can take screenshot up to here. So now we need to save it. Save in, where we have to save, not instead of save on desktop. Save. Here is image screenshot. Copy this, and we have to put in this evidence 3. Here is. So guys, this we have done. Now for the further evidence 4. create a web page called spring.htm. Guys, while designing this page, keep in mind efficient markup and CSS we can use to develop this page. This page must work in all browsers and all will have table structure as shown below. This page we need. Each table cell is identified with a letter and all dimensions are in pixels. The letters and dimensions shown in the table must not appear in your final web page. It means letters and dimensions. Letters we can write in the beginning, later on we can delete because in the final page it should not display. Just to identify the columns, identify the cells, they have given these alphabets and dimensions. We don't need to show them in the final web page. Place in cell A test. Let us solve. Firstly, we structure this table in structure layer and presenting them using height width we can set in CSS. So let us do the work on structure layer and presentation layer both. We need to design a table spring.htm, and for that we can use Notepad++. So as I've in the beginning I've told you, we are going to use all open source softwares. We are not going to use any Microsoft product also, not any other helping software. We are using Notepad++, which is also open source and free. So new page, we can start and save it as in the same folder, GGG. It is a Cambridge question papers on the desktop. Let us design the page. Where is so we have created a page spring.htm and open with the test editor, not in Notepad++. Open with Notepad++, select. It has been opened. So we need to structure this table. Guys, we have to use efficient code. So efficient means efficiently we'll have to use code. For the dimensions of B, C, E, F, G, H, I, and J. For all these cells, the dimensions are same. So instead of writing the code for them again and again, we can use the code efficiently. Means we can reduce the redundancy. We can group all these cells in a single. So for all these, we can design a single code. Firstly, we'll write the dimensions for, set the dimensions for A. So let us start the table. Firstly, HTML, then head, then title, spring, title. Guys, let us start the style, internal style sheet. So first A. For A, we can set the dimensions. Width is 800 and height is 100 pixels. Width 800 pixels and height is 100 pixels. And for the cell B, you can identify them as ID. For writing ID, we can use hash. And hash B, C, E, F, G, H, I, J means instead of D, all except D, all A, B to J, we can use the same code. B, C, D, not D, E, F, G, H, and I. Width equal to, width is 300 by 225, 300 wide and height 225 pixels. Then for D, width they need 275 pixels. 275 pixels and height is 900 pixels. 900 pixels. And then we need key 800 by 150. Width 800 and height 150 pixels. So as in the beginning they have told colors should be in hexadecimal and all dimensions are in pixels. So let me verify. A 800 by 100, 800 by 100 pixels, and B, C, E, F, G, H, I, J 300 by 225, 300 pixels by 225, and D is 275 by 900, and the K is 800 by 150. So dimensions are set. Let us move further. All table borders must be visible and have width 2 pixels. So means outer borders and inner borders, all borders should be of 2 pixels and should be visible. So we'll have to set the property for the tables also. Table outer border TH and TD inner borders. So border 2 pixels. So this property also we have set. We have already set the dimensions. Let us design the body. Body. First, the table will have to start. Then TR, TD. Guys, there is a table 1, 2, 3. This is a cos span of 3 in cell A. Cos span 3. Here we can write A just to for our purpose. Later on we will delete this because in they have told okay, the letters and dimensions should not show in the final table. Later on we will delete them and write for just our just for in the beginning for just to see our cells. We can write and close that row and start the second row and then TD again. Here we need. Here we'll have to mention the ID also. ID equal to A, as we have mentioned in the CSS different IDs. ID B. Here B, TD close, and TR close, not TR close. Now we need B, C, and D. Then pocket. Here we need C. Again, face. Here is D. D caps. And in D we need to row span. Row span. How many rows will have to span? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 rows will have to span here. So row span 4. So this so been done. So now we need to draw C D up to here. We have done here up to here. We can copy it and K case. After D, E, and E. D already designed, so that is not need to do again. Close the row, just copy it and paste. F. Yes. G. Again. H. One more row we need. I. Not I. Here we need J. Then again TR, again last K, a cost span 3, ED ID equal to K, and cost span we need 1, 2, 3, and K. Close the table, close the body, then HTML. Let us check our table, how it looks. Is it look according to the question or not? So let us check. So table border is not showing, I think. What happened to this? Let us check border. So guys, as border is not showing in this, as border is required, we need to write here solid black and save it to show the border. Guys, we need to mention here solid and black, then it will show the borders. Otherwise, we have not mentioned. If we don't mention the color and the solid, then by default it will be in white in color, which mix with the background color it doesn't show. So we need to specify here solid and color of the border. So it should be in black, I think it's better. So see, the table is ready. Work is ready here. Yes. Here we get the row span how much? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I think row span 6 is required. We had done something wrong in D. We had done 4. Here 6 is required. Here do 6. Let us see again. It's okay, now good. The table is ready. Let's move further. So this 13 marks work we have already done. The next 2 marks, this you have to place in a cell A the test spring, flowers, trees and shrubs, and set this test as style H1 in cell A. Instead of writing A, put this one and set it as a H1. Here we need to close it. H1. Again save it. Then place in cell C apple, F test this, and in C we have to place apple. instead of C, we need to write paper, and in F is camellia. In F. And in H, cherry. And in J, this four set here. Firstly C, then F. He went wrong. After C, here I think B, here we need E, here we need F. Here is F. This should be here. Instead of here. F. Here will be G. And here H. This cherry will be here, match. Cherry, this one, match. Match. After that, here is I. Here is J. Table is up to J only. So these two are extra. So we need here four only. That said something wrong there. After H, we need it in cherry in H. Put H in cherry. There is cherry, and in a J, this was here. Let us check our table. Here is now okay. Now it's okay. So let's move further. Set this test as a style H2. All these we have to set H2 again. Here H2, copy it, yes. Here we need to close it, H2, copy, then here. And here, so let us save it and check again. So this done. Place in cell D the image this and saved in step 4, and B the image of apple tree in E this and G this and in I this image. So these images we have to set in different cells. In D we need to do this image. Firstly set in D, here we need the image. The code for the image is image src equal to this and set. Let us check has it been saved or not. So image is here, guys. In the markup, resize each of these images to 90 pixels wide and while maintaining the aspect ratio. Is we need to set the width and height will automatically be set to 90 pixel wide. As they have told, aspect ratio means we need to set the only width. Height will automatically in the aspect ratio will be adjusted. So let us write in this in markup. So we don't need to write in CSS. In markup, we need to mention the size. Here, width is 290. So let us check. This has been set. Put the different images as they have asked. Here we need apple in B. In B we need apple. Image src is equal to apple.jpg and width equal to 290. We can copy this and same you can paste in E and in G and in I. Let us check first. And here is images has been set. We'll have to change the images. So in the second we need this image. So change this image and cherry. Change this to cherry. And here we need this image. So let us save and check. All images are set as according they have instructed. Let us move further. Place in cell K the text, the this. Replace the text, insert your name, center number and candidate number here with your name, center number and candidate number. Set the text in style H3. So this work we have already done. Let us do this one too. Let us place this guy's test triple G dot est in H3 in K table. Let us copy where it is this one. Copy this test. The shortcut is Control C for copying and in place here in K and set H3. Here we need to write the name. HArdevinder Singh. Center number. Suppose N0001 and candidate number. Suppose that is a 0001. 0001. Here we have to cut. So this is done. Let us save it. Check. We stock a range spring class trees and shrubs suitable for most habitats. Our expert HArdevinder Singh, this will help you to identify the best trees and shrubs for your location. Use link to email them. Make this task we have completed. Now next 11th. Make only the test link to hyperlink the send email message to this with the subject to ask the expert. 5 marks this task. So this will have to do very carefully. 5 marks. So we'll have to write the test mail to make only test link hyperlinks in the image to this with the subject Ask the Expert. The same test which we have written in K. So we'll have to link it. So in the beginning, you can write HREF mail HREF. Firstly, you can do K anchor. Please notify mail to. Mail to, then colon, then select this, here, this one. Then guys, you can write question mark subject is equal to ask the expert. For covering the space, you can write %20. %20. Here, close it. Here you can put the anchor tag also, and here you can close the anchor tag. So let us check if it's working or not. Here, so let us check what's the problem. Yes guys, you have to mention anchor href is equal to mail to, then address to whom you are going to send the mail, then question mark, then set the subject or cc. You can mention here subject, cc, body, whatever you can do after putting the question marks here. Question mark body, if you want to write something in body. So here subject is equal to ask the expert. Just to remove the space, you cover the space, we write the %20. So let us save it and check. Already saved. So let us check our page. Ready. While clicking here, we are going to mailbox, and here the mention already, and the subject is also here. So guys, this is task has been finished. 5 marks, I think. Here, 5 marks task. Next, make sure appropriate text is displayed if an image is not available. In all images, we need to place appropriate text. Means alternate text. If image is not available, then that text should display. Again, we need to do the work, my dears. Here, you need to do here. Alt is equal to LIAC. Yes. And here we can write double quotes. Means if image will not be available, this test will display. So here, Alt, Apple, and here, Alt, Canada. Alt, Meet Sherry, and here Art F was. So let us check, is it working or not? Suppose Apple 1 image is not available. So is it showing the alternate or not? Let me check. Yes, it's showing that image is not available, and it's show Apple. So alternate text is showing. We have the Apple image. Save it. Okay. This task we have done. Attach the style sheet GGG style.css to your web page. So let us attach this style sheet to our web page. So guys, we need to attach this web style sheet, not this one, this style sheet. So let's check, is it available or not? Yes, this is GGG style.css is available. We need to attach this. Guys, if we are working in Notepad++, we need to remember the code. We are using any helping software like Front Page, Microsoft Front Page, or Microsoft Web Expression, then we can use GUI or options for that. For here, we need to learn the code. So for this link, rel equal to style sheet, then type equal to test CSS, and then hyper reference href is equal to the address of that sheet, which is this one. Copy this and paste here. And then this has been saved. Let us check it. Yes, this has been attached. So let us move further. Save the web page with ggg.html folder. The page has we have already saved. You will create a second style sheet using the most efficient syntax. Make sure your style sheet does not contain any HTML. So we need to make an external style sheet clearly. If they are clearly said that there should not be a HTML. If we are using internal style sheet, means HTML will be there obviously. So we need to make an external style sheet without any HTML code, completely with the CSS. Create a new style sheet called trip GGG followed by your candidate number. For example, this one. Place your name, center number, and candidate number as a comment at the bottom of the style sheet. Edit the style sheet so that the image GGG logo.png becomes a single background image placed at the top right of each page. We are having a single page, so it will display only on that page. All tables are left lined in the browser. All table borders are visible and 2 pixels wide. This we have already done. We don't need to do it again. Save your style sheet and attach to your web page. Make sure your new style sheet has a higher priority than the previous one, which we have already attached. So then next, display the web page in your web browser. This is the next task, I think. So we need to do up to here first. So let us start. Let us create this file GGG followed by your candidate number 0001.css. So your new save as here. We need to write our own candidate number 0001 and save it. Now follow the instructions. You'll have to paste your center. Later on we can write the image triple G logo. Single background image placed on the top right. Let us do. That is body attribute. Background. URL and that will be background image URL. The image is this one. Copy this, not this, control C. And save. Next, they have told that there should be on a position top right. Position right. Right. So background repeat should be no repeat. No repeat. No. No repeat. Let us check is as the image came on its position or not. So for that we need to attach this file. So let us attach. Control C, Control V. Here we need this one. So, this has been attached. Let us check. Yes, this is on our top left. We need it on top right. I think we need a right top instead of top right. Yes. Position top right. Let us try again. That is right top. Let us check. Position right top. Not working. Should be, I think, background position. Yes, it's now on the right top. Image has been set down, and now further, there we all the tables are left aligned in the browser. For table, we need to write left align table. Or you can say position table position. Table position is not available. Margin 0 pixel. So means 0 pixel means top left. Automatically it will come on the top left. 0 pixels. So let us check. Yes, it has come. So if we have mentioned the 0 pixels means top right, top left, 0 top and left also 0. So top left it will be placed here. So next further, table left line in our browsers are. Tables are border are visible 2 pixels, which we have already done in the previous style sheet. Save your style sheet and attach it to your web page, which we have already done. Make sure your new style sheet has been higher property than this previous one. So guys, we have already kept in the below this. This was the old one and this was the new one. The later on which we will attach after that will be having a high priority. The previous one this. After that we attach this new one. So this is having a high priority as compared to this one. So if we will reverse order, then this will come on the high priority. So in this, the table is centrally aligned, and in this with high priority is on the left line. Let us try after changing it. Let us check here. Now see, the table has come in a center because and this, the previous one is having a high priority. Now we are again exchanging to give the high priority to the new one, which we have made. So this is having a high priority. So the style sheet which you will attach later, that will be having a high priority. So now next, what they are asking for, save your style sheet and attach, which we have already done. This 9 marks work we have done. Now display the web page in your web browser. If necessary, resize so that all the pages page can be seen or text can be easily be read. The address bar is visible. Take a screenshot and browse of the browser window and place in the evidence document, evidence pool. So let us see, this should be resized 70%, no more. Now it is visible, 50% is visible. Take the screenshot. Grab the whole screen, select the area to grab. From here to here, we can take the screenshot. This will be a web page. So take this web page, copy it, and place in evidence folder. So where this has been done, now save it and further display the new style sheet in your editor. Take copy of your new style sheet and place in your evidence document 6. So here this we don't need, I think this is required, and here we need to copy all. Here one thing we lost, we need to here write your name, center number, and your candidate number, and save it. Display the new style sheet in your editor. Take the copy of new style sheet and place in your evidence document 6. So take its copy and 6. Where is 6? Where is 5? What to do in 5? Copy HTML code. HTML code we need to copy first. Here. Copy this one and place here. This code we have copied and in evidence 6 we need to copy this CSS code. Copy it and paste here. Save it again. So this task 2, 50 marks has been completed. Spreadsheet we will cover in later on, and then we need to take the print out this. Let us check the print preview. Print preview. Here 100%. So these are all our pages we have done. Is all tasks we have completed. Task 1, evidence 2, 3, and 7 we will discuss in next video. Let us check again print preview. We check a single page. So this evidence 1, our name, candidate number, and center number must be shown on the header on every page. Make sure and check your all and then give the command of printing. So this was your task 2, web authoring, which we have completed. In next video we will complete the spreadsheet task. Thanks for watching. Thank you very much.